Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to WS Cube Tech English channel. Myself, Omar Taskeer. Because in this particular video, we are basically going to see that how can we actually create an app install campaign from the very scratch. We know about the basics of app install campaigns, how they actually look like, and what are the different options which are present in creating app install campaign. So let's begin and create an app install campaign from the very scratch. So we have to start from those basic steps. We have to come to our campaign section over here, and then we have to go to this plus section, then we have to go to new campaign, we have to create an app install campaign. We can select this thing also, like create a campaign without a goal guidance, and then we can go to app install campaign from here, or we can also select this one, right, app promotion, and then we can select a campaign subtype, which is app install, which is now our requirement, because we are not looking to create an app engagement related campaign. We want to increase the numbers of installs in our app, right? So now we have selected this app. We have both the options available over here. Either we can go with this campaign without a goal guidance, or we can choose this app promotion option also, right? So let it be selected like this only, app install, and then we will click on this Android over here, and then we'll put our app name, right? So since we haven't selected any app, now what we can do is basically, so now I have selected my app. Now we have to click on continue, and then we have to write our campaign name, right? So this is app install for Learn Digital Marketing app. So we can write it like this. It will basically indicate that what kind of campaign it is. So it is app install for Learn Digital Marketing. Now we have options of like setting up location. So I'll be setting up India, and I want to advertise in all the location. Now I'll put my budget to be ₹500, and I'll bid on install volume. It will be for all the users, and I'll set a target cost per install, which is basically optional. But yes, I'll set it over here like for ₹5, and then I'll see how much cost per install I am getting. If I am not getting good cost per installs, and I think my other campaign settings are good, then I can basically increase my cost per install, right? The amount that we have set over here. So that will come into the optimization part, where you are basically playing with the cost per install amount, or the target cost per install, what you have entered over here, right? You will be playing with that particular thing. You'll be increasing, decreasing, depending on how your campaign is performing, right? So we will be ignoring this thing for now, like start and end dates, it's not required. So now we have set few things over here, and then we have advanced settings also over here, which is related to data feed. Again, it is not required at this moment of time. Now we have set like campaign name, and we have set locations, we have set languages, budgets, bidding, and bidding is basically how much amount we want to pay for like for a single install, right? And what will be the strategy for bidding, or what will be our main focus while we are bidding, that is like install volume, and then we have all users and our target cost per install. So we have set these things now. So these are the only settings that are there at the campaign level, and then we have to go to ad group level, and there we have to enter the assets, right? So as soon as we are at the ad group level, now we have the options of entering the different ad assets, and these ad assets will combine together to form an ad for us, and that will be that ad particularly will be shown on different placements, like on display network, search network, YouTube network, and like discovery network and Google Play, right? So our ad, which will be made from different ad assets, will show up over here on these different platforms. So we have different ad assets over here, and you can see what is written over here is your ads are generated from the text ideas that you are going to put over here under the headlines and the descriptions. And also your uploaded assets will also contribute in generating your ads, and content from your Google Play Store. So whatever app is listed on your Google Play Store, so different assets from there also will also come into the picture, and they will again constitute to form a complete ad for you. And if your app is on Apple App Store, then it will pick up the assets from there also, right? So in this particular example, we know that we have selected an Android app. So it will be picking up the different assets of a Play Store only, right? So we have different ad assets over here, and now we have to enter the headlines, right? So we can start the headlines like Learn Digital Marketing, okay? And then we can write over here like Learn SEO, SMO, PPC. Okay, and Master Digital Marketing. Now what we can write is Learn Digital Marketing in Hindi. So these are the different statements that we can use in Hindi, perfect. Let me see if it is coming in the defined character limit or not. It is not coming. So let's leave this thing. Learn, we can write online marketing over here, right? And then we can write learn search engine optimization. I'm not sure, will it come or not? Okay, it is not coming. So we can write search engine optimization tips over here. That will come, I believe. Yes, no, it's not coming. So we will write only search engine optimization. So we can put different headlines over here. And now you can see over here what it is showing, that okay, you have put 5 headlines over here. So it is fine now. And then we have to put some description also, and that is of like 90 characters. So I'm putting like learn digital marketing, like, or we can write master digital marketing. So what we can write over here is master digital marketing, learn SEO, SMO and PPC advertising, learn in a fun way, test your knowledge in digital marketing through quizzes available. So now I'm writing it very randomly. You have the options, and you have to look after your app. You have to see what kind of features, functions and options are available there in your app. Then you have to decide that what you are going to write over here, right? So we have entered 2 descriptions over here. Then we have the options of adding images. We can add images. So let me show you if we are adding like normal images. Recently used and your assets, no images we can find over here, but we'll be selecting some random images. Okay, so I'm having some images over here, and let's select this one. So this is basically out of dimension, that is why it was creating problem. Now let us select any other image if we have. Let me select this one if it is working. No, it is again not working. So we have to look after these dimensions and everything. Then we have to upload the images over here. Then we can also upload some videos over here. We can also work on the HTML5 content over here. So we can do all these things. We can upload all these things, and we can see the preview, how it is actually looking. Once all these things are done, now what you have to do is you have to simply click on save and continue, and that's it. Your campaign is almost ready. Your campaign is almost ready to fire. And now what you can do is basically you can see over here what kind of settings you have kept over here, right? I'll recommend you to use as much as ad assets you can. And if you are actually providing more ad assets to Google system, then Google will have more option to mix and match your ads, right? Ad assets. And that will basically help in optimizing your performance. So this is how you can create a simple basic app install campaign. And it's not like that you have created your app install campaign, it will keep running, right? You have to optimize it. It's not only limited to app install campaign. For each and every campaign, the setting up of campaign is the first part, right? Your first campaign is never your last campaign. Your first setting is never your last setting in your campaign. So whenever you are looking for some result oriented campaigns, what you have to do is basically you have to keep testing things. You have to keep optimizing your campaign, no matter what kind of campaign it is, right? It can be like app install campaign, it can be like search campaign. Everywhere you actually need optimization to make your campaign stand out. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.